When air expands adiabatically, meaning without gaining or losing heat, its pressure and volume are related by the equation P times V raised to the power of 1.4 equals C, where C is a constant, P is the pressure, and V is the volume. Suppose at a certain instant the volume is 350 cubic centimeters and the pressure is 70 kilopascals and is decreasing at a rate of 10 kilopascals per minute. At what rate in cubic centimeters per minute is the volume increasing at that instant? So to solve this problem, we'll be using the given equation P times V raised to the power of 1.4 equals C. We also want to consider when the volume is exactly 350 cubic centimeters. So we know V equals 350. We also know the pressure is 70 kilopascals. But the pressure is also decreasing at a rate of 10 kilopascals per minute, which means dP dt, or the change in the pressure with respect to time, is equal to negative 10 kilopascals per minute. And our goal is to find the rate of change of the volume at this instant, so we want to find dV dt. So to solve this problem, we're going to differentiate this equation here with respect to t. Notice because we're differentiating with respect to t, we'll have to perform implicit differentiation. And also on this left side here, since we have a product of p and v to the 1/4, we'll have to apply the product rule in order to find this derivative with respect to t. And then once we find the derivative with respect to t, we can perform substitution with the known values to find dv dt. Let's go ahead and find this derivative on the next slide. So again, to find the derivative here, we'll have to apply the product rule. So we'll have the first function p times the derivative of the second function with respect to t plus the second function times the derivative of the first function with respect to t. This is still equal to the derivative of a constant with respect to t. Now we'll go back and find the derivatives with respect to t. So we'll have p times the derivative of v raised to the power of 1.4 with respect to t. We'll apply the power rule with the chain rule. So we'll have 1.4 v to the power of 1.4 minus 1, or 0.4, times dv dt. Again, we have this extra factor here because this is given in terms of v, and we're differentiating with respect to t. And we'll have plus v to the power of 1.4 times the derivative of p with respect to t, which would be 1 times dp dt, or just dp dt, equals the derivative of a constant with respect to t would just be 0. And remember, our goal here is to solve for dv dt. So now we'll solve the equation for dv dt. Let's start by subtracting this product here on both sides of the equation. We can write this as 1.4 p v to the power of 0.4 times dv dt equals, we'd have negative v to the 1.4th power times dp dt. And now to solve for dv dt, we'll divide both sides by 1.4 p v to the power of 0.4. Or the change in the volume with respect to time is equal to negative v to the power of 1.4 times dp dt divided by 1.4 times p v to the power of 0.4. And now to find dv dt, we can substitute 350 for v, 70 for p, negative 10 for dp dt, and then simplify to find dv dt. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So we would have dv dt equals negative 350 raised to the power of 1.4 times dp dt, which is negative 10, divided by 1.4 times p, which is 70, times v raised to the power of 0.4. To save some time, I've already determined this value. Dv dt is approximately equal to 35.714. Again, this is the change in the volume with respect to time. So this is going to be cubic centimeters per minute. So the volume is increasing because this is positive at a rate of approximately 35.714 cubic centimeters per minute when the volume is 350 cubic centimeters, the pressure is 70 kilopascals, and the pressure is dropping at a rate of 10 kilopascals per minute. It is important to recognize that the volume is only changing at this rate given these conditions. If these conditions were different, it would change the rate at which the volume is changing. I hope you found this explanation helpful.